Novelty Audiobook present The Rebirth of the Malicious Empress of Military Lineage, Chapter 6, Undercurrent. Shen King looked at her own mother with an unknowing look. Even though she was unwilling, she still obediently kept her mouth shut. Even though Shen Yu did not understand what was wrong with Shen Miao's words, upon seeing Chen Rikayu's nervous expression, she was aware what was going on and thus stood at her place respectfully and no longer spoke. Old Shen Furen's brows tightened. Even though she has followed old General Shen for so many years, she did not know the intricate twists and turns of the official circles, as her sights were confined to the skies between the four walls of the courtyards. So how could she understand the meaning behind Shen Miao's words? She only felt that Shen Miao ate the wrong medication today and repeatedly contradicted her, and thus felt offended and wanted to blow up in anger. Little Five's words are not wrong. Ren Wan Yun smiled and interrupted when old Shen Furen was about to lash out. This was originally a misunderstanding. How could the matter of the main hall be spread to the inner courtyard? This was all a coincidence. His Highness Prince Ding is broad-minded and would not put such a small matter at heart. It was all a misunderstanding. It is unfortunate for our little five who fell into the water and got a shock. You have suffered a lot. Old Shen Furen had opened her mouth and was somewhat dissatisfied with her second daughter-in-law who had interrupted her. But Ren Wan Yun's family was Ming Qi's famous merchant family, and many times the daily cost was subsidies by this daughter-in-law. Even though she was not satisfied, she could not offend her. She immediately rumped coldly but did not continue on. Chen Ruzayu seemed to be aware of it and also went along with Ren Wan Yun's words. That is precisely so. In future, you and King must never mention the words before. It was Little Five that fell into the water accidentally and coincidentally seen by His Highness Prince Ding. There are coincidences in the world. She smiled towards Shen Miao. Little Five, old Furen feel anguished for you and was not truly angry with you. Shen Miao look at the female in front. Shen Yu took after Chen Rikayu, that even her temperament was the same. Chen Rikayu was born in a family of scholars, thus she was a graceful beauty and usually soft and gentle when walking or talking, and was beautiful but not frivolous. Such a female with a literary vibe was also a good partner, but who knew what happened later. Later, the Zhang Nu came over to request for a marriage alliance, and there was only one age-appropriate princess, Wan Yu. Chen Rikayu said that Shen Yu is older, and a marriage alliance was also a marriage, so she was willing to marry to the Zhang Nu. But Shen Yu was not a princess, so Fu Ziyu Yi conferred Shen Yu as Princess Yuru so that it was justifiable for her to be in a marriage alliance with the Zhang Nu. But at the end, the one who was married off was her Wan Yu. Wan Yu died on the way to marriage, and Wan Yu's princess's residence was given to Prince Yuru, in which Princess Yuru was expected to receive everything of Wan Yu's. Her Wan Yu was not even 16 years old. Shen Miao closed her eyes. If one say that Chen Rikayu did not put an effort to this matter, Chen Rikayu herself would also not believe. But one would be afraid that Chen Rikayu would have already reached an agreement with Mai Furen, and the main reason was to let her think that there was hope, but then shatter that hope by herself. Chen Ryuokayu's smile stiffened. The young female that was facing her was looking at her. That round face, round eyes, round nose, and coupled with the timid appearance, it would easily leave an impression of stupidity and foolishness. But now it was otherwise. She did not know when the timid appearance had disappeared and it was replaced with solemnness. Not a sudden tension of seriousness, but it was a type of slight feeling of distance. There was a moment when Chen Rikayu suddenly felt that the person in front was not the stupid and foolish daughter of the first household, but some mistress of a higher status and power. The kind that would make smarter and sharper people shiver. In the next second, one could see that the young female turned her eyes. I believe that third Qian Shan also felt that Little Five is also not wrong. Chen Rikayu was surprised for a moment as she looked at the displeasure of the old Furen sitting at a higher level, and said reluctantly, "Be that as it may, it was really too careless of Little Five to fall into the pond. How do the few maids beside you take care of people? Eldest brother and eldest sister-in-law is not by one side, so the maids started to bully the masters." According to what Shin Shin see, It would be better to replace these maids. Ran Wan Yun laugh escaped with a pukai sound. Chen Rikayu glared at her somewhat angrily and a sneer was formed on Ren Wan Yun lips. Her this demi looked like a well-educated person but her heart was extremely shrewd. These kind of words can only be used to deceive that foolish Shen Miao. She most likely want to change the people by Shen Miao's side. At the moment Shen Yu has also reached the age where one would start paying attention and in the capital. No matter how far Shen Miao's foolish or stupid reputation has spread, in terms of status, Shen Yu's was unable to be compared as Shen Miao's. After all, Shen Xin still held the military power in his hands. At the end, the third household was also ready to create trouble. Shen Miao lowered her head. Why would third Shen want to replace Gu Yu and the rest? Since they are all dad's and mom's people. At present there are many personnel changes in the West Courtyard. Just few days ago, a batch of second rank maids were sent over and Fifth Lady did not recognize a single one. If Gu Yu and the rest are changed then Fifth Lady would not know who to talk to in the West Courtyard. Ren Wan Yu's smile stopped short. In the West Courtyard, Shen Xin and his wife were not in the capital most of the year and most of the maids in the courtyard have been changed. There were old Furin's people, second households people and third households people. But because the second household was managing the family, so naturally there were more people from the second household. If these words were not said it would be better, if this was spread to outsiders that the daughter of the first household did not know any single servant in her own courtyard, what intentions did the second and third household have? There was no logic that a younger sister-in-law that could intervene in the courtyard of the eldest brother. Her brain started to turn quickly as she smiled and gave Chen Rikayu a look before saying to Shen Miao, "Your third Shen is joking with you. Gu Yu and the few maids are just careless and sloppy but we the Shen family is benevolence and cannot bear to do such inhuman things. Little Five must not be anxious." The words at the end was choked out from Chen Rikayu. Shen Yuanbo looked at his mother and then looked over at Chen Rikayu before yawning. Old Shen Furin was getting impatient with her own second and third daughter-in-law when she saw the scene and said, "That's enough. It's only some trivial matter. Second son's family, carry seventh son over and then disperse. So many people making so much noise that made one's head dizzy." Ren Wan Yu quickly carried Shen Yuanbo to old Shen Furin's couch and say, "Mother, then these daughter-in-laws will go first. Seventh son will play obediently with old Furin." Chen Rikayu glanced over at Shen Yuanbo and both her hands went up to her belly as she slowly exited from Rong Jingdang. The second household had sons so they were looked upon highly by old Shen Furin. So what if she had the ability? Shen Yu was still a daughter. It would be good if she had a son. In the Shen residence, the things from the first residence would need to be fought over and if she had a son, at least there would be equal shares, not like now, letting the second household have all the advantage. Moreover, there was still a son in the first household. Even though he followed Shen Xin to the border, who would know if he would come back to fight for a share? After much thinking, Chen Rikayu raised her head and her eyes landed on the direction of the people heading towards the west courtyard. The young female was wearing a dark red embroidered dress as she always loved to wear brightly colored ones. In addition, with no parents at her side, she did not know how to dress up and would always portray an unsophisticated look. But now, the crimson color of the clothes made her complexion fairer. She was obviously still had the same appearance but one felt that she was much more solemn. And there was also some imposing air. Gu Yu softly said, "Young lady's health is not recovered yet. Why the hurry to head to the academy?" Since the health condition was already explained, the homework would not be in rush to complete. It would be better. "No." Shi Miao interrupted her words. "Prepare the carriage immediately." It was clearly not harsh words but Gu Yu did not know why she had a shiver and dare not ask more.